heard my ankle crack, and you know, just got out, tightened it, put some tape on, and just kept going to battle with my team.
Could you feel that? Was it like hurting a lot after that?
It was hurting until they taped it. When I taped it, I was just trying to go through it. I'll never give up. And you know, coaches pulled me out, and I had no choice but to tape it, and it felt better after that.
Did you get a sense for how many points you were scoring, and you know how close you were to having a career high and that kind of thing?
Nah, not really. I was just trying to get the W. You know, I was trying to play on the defense end, and then offense let my game come to me, and my teammates believed in me, and I believed in them. So I really wasn't worried. I was just trying to win.
And this game, it was their personnel, or it was their scheme that allowed you to get to the run so easily?
I mean, I don't know. I ain't in their locker room. I mean, I just went out and, you know, do what I do and try to do what I do, so.
Andrew, you said this kind of thing is coming. You said in the past you're going to have an off night and other guys are going to step up. I mean, when he's going, Mikey's going. You know, what advice are you guys saying as a team as far as when you're on offense?
Really, run the same play. I think you try and get us both in the same action. Because usually if teams keying in on either one of us, like I said that earlier on in the year, you won't be able to stop both of us. That's just not going to happen. So either I'm going to have 30 or he's going to have 30 pretty much. So once he gets going, I just keep running the same play, to be honest. Keep letting him make plays, and then until they want to stop it, and if they don't want to stop it, he can have big games.
Andrew, you guys want to play fast. I mean, there's just so many foul calls and so many stoppages for reviews. How did that impact the game tonight?
A bunch. I'm not one to sit up here and talk about the refs. I mean, that refereeing is one of the hardest jobs in the world, but I mean, something has to change. With that being said, I mean, there was a lot of complaining on both sides of the benches, so I don't think it was one-sided. I felt it was on step. I felt the same way, just what the players were saying on the court. But I mean, Coach Romo does a good job of telling us to play through it. I think no matter what, it's still basketball, still got to play the game. Don't let it affect you.
What happened about that double play,
man? The dude elbowed me in the face, and I was just trying to get back, and I elbowed him on accident, but it was the right call. I think they could have got that one right.
The difference between the first half and the second half is what?
For us, I think it was our defense, and then we start seeing the ball go in. I think the gym was electric. I think they really keyed us coming back. They got them kind of rattled or whatever at the free throw line. They were making a lot of free throws in that first half, and in the second half, the building was kind of loud and electric. They started missing, and then we were able to kind of get out and get easy baskets. Baby was going both first half and second half, which keyed us the whole game.
That three that you made in the overtime, you looked like a pretty relieved guy when that went in. Is it just, how tough is it to try to break through like a mini slump?
Man, I haven't shot like that. Like, usually, like, contested shots I'll miss, but those ones, I'll get a lot of wide open shots, and I just wasn't making them. But Barry was the whole time, coaching staff telling me, keep shooting, it's going to drop. And when he fouled out, first thing he comes to me and says is, pretty much, you got to win this game for us. So just hearing that and just having the belief in my teammates and just the belief in myself, I know I'm not going to miss all my open shots. So just keep shooting, keep firing, let it go.
Anything else?
David, what can you just comment? Beach beat Garfield last night, Nate's up in the crowd.
You know, it's definitely, you know, a good feeling going back, seeing my high school win. You know, I lost in state championship to Garfield. So, you know, it was definitely a good feeling seeing them win. But, you know, I support the youth. I support both teams. And, you know, I just told the Rainier Beach dudes, don't get comfortable. Because we beat them last year, too. And they ended up beating us later on in the county. So, you know, and it was great to have Nate here for the first time. I feel like if he's here in town, he should come a lot.
Thanks, guys.